Oh, no, you won't.
Oh, yes, we will.
Christmas greetings from the Costadel Crime with the El Cid boys, Bromley and Blake, enjoying the season of goodwill, a time of giving and getting your home nicked.
It's gone.
And the name of the boat, senor.
Couldn't we leave the paperwork till later?
Blake doesn't believe in Father Christmas, and for Bromley, everything's falling apart.
I'll give you another statement. Two words, short and sweet.
Just when they thought it was safe to enjoy Christmas, El Cid returns this New Year's Day at 9.
Merry Christmas.
If you're in business and don't want to give your clients the cold shoulder, get a great deal on water heaters. Free phone Norweb Network. Now for details.
Happiness is a cigar called Hamlet, the mild cigar.
Good job it wasn't deep, Grandad.
Well, it's only a boating mate, love.
Whatever have you been up to?
It wasn't his fault, Nana.
I just slipped.
He was rescuing us from the aliens.
Oh, we were only playing.
Well, you ought to know better at your age. Now get out of those mucky things, all of you. Can't have your mother see you looking like that. Oh, you looked so nice when you came.
How old are you now?
I'm 61, sweetheart.
And how old is Grandad?
About 12.
Name sale starts on Thursday, so hurry before all the bargains have gone.
Hello. You may be feeling everyone else is having a great time this Christmas except you. Well, if you're feeling like that, or a little bit depressed, or you've got a practical problem like where can you get an electrician or a chemist, we might be able to help. Ring the Granada Christmas Care Line on 061 832 8088.
Boxing Day on Granada. They used to call her baby. That was before she discovered dirty dancing.
Where did they learn to do that?
Where? I don't know. Kids are doing it in the basements back home.
Then she met Johnny.
Well, if it isn't the entertainment staff.
Listen, Wiseass, no funny business, no conversations, and keep your hands off.
Now he's teaching her all about dirty dancing. Patrick Swayze stars as the irresistible Johnny in the movie premiere, Dirty Dancing, Boxing Day at 8 on Granada.
And right now on Granada, the latest world news from ITN with Richard Barth.
The news from ITN.
Gorbachev wins sweeping new powers from the Soviet Parliament. The Queen remembers the troops in the Gulf and condemns Iraq. Christmas churchgoers escape death as gales sweep across Britain. And gifts for the Red Army from the Germans they once dominated. Good evening. President Gorbachev has won a crucial vote which tightens his grip on the Soviet Union. His parliament voted to create a powerful new cabinet under his direct control. But he's still to pass radical changes tying all the republics to Moscow. And Boris Yeltsin, the leader of the Russian Republic, says he'll boycott that move.
President Gorbachev is now one step closer to the power he seeks, the right to rule his vast empire by presidential decree. In a clear victory for the Soviet president and the conservative hardliners, Congress today approved two-thirds of the constitutional changes he wants. The deputies voted to give him direct control over a streamlined cabinet. There's also to be a new post of vice president. All of this gives Mikhail Gorbachev some of the powers he says he now must have to halt the country's slide into political and economic crisis. But with representatives from five republics already boycotting this Congress, power on paper may not be enough. What Mr. Gorbachev needs is countrywide authority.
I think he has every power he could obtain for the time being. I do not understand why he needs more. What he needs today is the trust and confidence of the people, and this is what he is lacking today.
Arch-rival Boris Yeltsin, leader of the Russian parliament, gave notice that his republic would resist Kremlin commands, an ominous signal for a more powerful Mr. Gorbachev. The president himself urged the rebellious republics to rally around him now, saying he'd use his new powers wisely. I've strong democratic roots, he said. The head of the KGB once again warned of increasing lawlessness. He claimed that some food sent from abroad is already falling into the hands of black marketeers. Mr. Gorbachev will tomorrow ask Parliament to put the seal on his sweeping new presidential powers. But he must still prove he has the authority to use those powers if he's to stop restless hardliners seeking an alternative leader. Penny Marshall, ITN, Moscow.
The Queen has described Iraq's invasion of Kuwait as an example of evil. In her Christmas address, she said her thoughts were with the British troops in the Gulf and their families here. The Queen also spoke of the suffering caused by the scourge of terrorism in the United Kingdom.
The invasion of Kuwait was an example on an international scale of an evil which has beset us at different levels in recent years. Attempts by ruthless people to impose their will on the peaceable majority. In extreme form, as we know only too well, these attempts lead to disaster and death, and their tragic aftermath for families and communities. In the United Kingdom, we have suffered once again during the past year from the scourge of terrorism. Its disregard for human life and its efforts to dress its crimes in political clothes.
British forces in the Gulf have been celebrating Christmas as best they can. The troops remain on alert because of the threat of war.
He's the most experienced Tornado pilot in the RAF. Paul Brown and his navigator up at dawn, preparing to spend much of the Christmas day high above the Saudi-Kuwait border. The squadron leader's mission today, the same as always, to intercept Iraqi fighters. Christmas has been a time of stress and of constant fear over what the next mission will bring. It was a routine patrol, but there was nothing routine at the base a few minutes later.
Get into that, quickly.
This was no practice, as news was flashed to the airbase that the Iraqis had launched Scud missiles. The RAF detachment went on immediate alert, putting on their protective gear and ordered to take shelter in a nearby bunker.
Take shelter.
Only later was it identified as a false alarm. But every alert here is taken seriously. Out in the desert, while the soldiers did relax, the officers guarded camp perimeters. The Royal Artillery found time this morning for a carol service in a local quarry. The Christian nature of the service was played down so not to offend the Muslim authorities. Before returning to their camps, the men of the 40th Field Regiment were asked to remember Saddam Hussein in their prayers. Robert Moore, ITN, Saudi Arabia.
Iraq has warned President Bush that he'll be gambling the lives of tens of thousands of American troops if he goes to war against Iraq. In Baghdad, the remaining Western residents and diplomats have been celebrating Christmas.
As Christmas Day dawned, prayers were being said in churches around the country for peace. At St. Raphael's Catholic Church, children brought a local flavour to the traditional nativity scene of today's service. Around the family Christmas tree, the scene is much the same as it is right across the Christian world.
Yes, have opened them up nicely, darling. Hey,
the difference here is the real threat of war next month. Although Norman and Teresa Hughes don't want to join the people who've gone.
You have very few foreigners left here in Baghdad and very, very few Western people and family. But the situation is that our own children are happy here and are going to school. And they have little friends of their own, and we're happy here at the present moment anyway.
There are very few British left here now, less than 40, to listen on crackling shortwave radios to the Queen's Christmas message.
A happy Christmas and God bless you all.
Just a handful of embassy staff left to join together for Christmas lunch, a turkey carved by acting ambassador Christopher Seeger, and a few guests, like Norman Green, still looking for an exit visa.
Happy Christmas and a happy new year.
For the moment, the thought of war has been put to one side. Desmond Hamill, ITN, Baghdad.
The Archbishop of Canterbury, Dr. Robert Runcie, says war in the Gulf should be a last resort. In his last Christmas sermon at Canterbury as Archbishop, he spoke out against the glorification of war and violence on television.
Mass entertainment can pander to this cult of violence, bringing fighting and murder into our living rooms as a spectacle to be seen from our armchairs, and distancing violence from the pain, remorse and grief which inevitably follow it.
In his Christmas message, the Pope urged world leaders to realise that a war in the Gulf would be an adventure with no return. After the address, he read out Christmas greetings in 53 languages.
May the light that came into the world this blessed day shine in your hearts and in your homes always.
Severe weather warnings were issued tonight, with weather forecasters predicting structural damage in some places. The gales have already cut power supplies to thousands of homes. Kent, Hampshire, Worcestershire and Staffordshire were worst affected. And in Wiltshire, five people were hurt when part of a church tower collapsed.
Masonry crashed down on the congregation during the Christmas morning service at Kington St. Michael Parish Church near Chippenham. The gale force winds brought down one of the four corner pinnacles of the church tower. Debris landed inches away from the priests conducting the service, and it was fortunate that the largest piece of masonry lodged in the rafters. Five of the congregation were treated in hospital for minor injuries. Elsewhere, the storms brought down trees and power lines and caused some road closures. At Cheddar in Somerset, many homes were left without electricity as winds of up to 70 miles an hour toppled chimney pots and stripped away roof tiles. Firemen were called in to help with emergency repairs. At Chelwood near Bath, outbuildings were wrecked and families had to delay Christmas lunch while they cleared away the mess.
Great, terrific.
At Sandringham, the Queen and members of the royal family braved the bad weather as they attended church this morning. The Queen and Queen Mother held on to their hats. The Princess of Wales lost hers. The crowds who came to see them had to turn their backs for protection against the storm. For those planning to venture out tomorrow, the forecast is more bad weather.
Iran has rejected the author Salman Rushdie's attempt to make peace over his controversial book, The Satanic Verses. A hardline Tehran newspaper says the two-year-old death sentence against him still stands. Yesterday, Mr. Rushdie said he wouldn't publish a paperback version of his book. Finally, the Christmas spirit overcame the old east-west divisions in Berlin. Families there invited Red Army soldiers to join them for Christmas dinner. Stuart Meister at ITN reports.
They were the symbol of Soviet domination. Now they're seen by many in Germany simply as soldiers a long way from home. In the spirit of Christmas, a small army of local people have delivered presents to them with the blessing of the newly image-conscious Red Army.
Of course, soldiers are just a little bit curious about the way the Germans are celebrating the Christmas, because Christmas isn't a state holiday in the Soviet Union.
Sasha and Zhenya, both from the Ukraine, are among hundreds who've been invited into German homes to satisfy that curiosity. Faced with a traditional turkey and all the trimmings, 24-year-old Sasha said he'd never seen such luxury and only hoped the Soviet Union will achieve such a standard one day. But because too many Soviet soldiers have asked for asylum or have been harassed by resentful Germans, most of the estimated 360,000 troops have not been allowed out like this. So presents have been taken to their...